Williams. He's a multiple Grammy winner, Paul Williams, and obviously also the president of ASCAP.
President of ASCAP, and I got to take a moment just to celebrate the technology of YouTube, Facebook. I mean, when you look at what's going on right now in Egypt, everybody has to be jumping up and down with, look at, has there ever been a technology created that was used more brilliantly and more lovingly than this day? So
yeah,
you have to mention that.
Yes, there's a lot of power in all these tools.
Oh yeah, and you know what, at ASCAP, we love technology. There's more music being played more places in the world right now than ever before. What we do want to make sure is that there are continue to make sure that people can make a viable living at it. You know, Bill Withers and I were in Washington, D.C. talking to a senator, and Bill Withers said to a senator, you know, Senator, you got to make sure these kids can make a living at writing songs, because if we don't, then we're going to have to get day jobs. And Senator, you do not want Ozzy Osbourne as your plumber.
So. That would be scary.
That would be frightening.
Actually, I would like to take some pictures of that. I'm sure that would go viral.
Ozzy working on a toilet? It's frightening.
Well, so how are these tools changing what you're doing, and where do you see this all going?
Well, it's a great, you know, it's a challenge. You know, the technology has always outrun the law, but the fact is this technology is brilliant. This technology is bringing music to people in every, I mean, like, my wife is always screaming at me, step away from the iPhone, step away from the iPhone and get back in the room. But what it has done is it's just splintered music all over the place in every form, and we're just trying to keep up with the technology and make sure that when people download music, you know, and when they're enjoying music,
yeah,
that a little taste is going to the writers and the artists that sing it,
exactly,
and they can make a good living.
Now, I need to talk about, of course, being here, Barbara Streisand.
Wow.
And your experience with her and what it means for you to be here tonight.
Well, you know, she recorded the first of one of my songs back in the early 70s, and then the big phone call was in 1976 when she asked me to write the songs for A Star Is Born. We won the Oscar and the Grammy and the Golden Globe with Evergreen, which she wrote the music to and I wrote the lyrics for. The one moment I've ever seen her absolutely shy, I mean absolutely shy, like a little girl, was holding the guitar, playing the music for what became Evergreen, and asking me if I liked it. And I said, do I like it? Duh, it's gorgeous.
She made her nervous.
No, I think she was shy about it because writing was a new thing for her, you know. So, but she's an amazing artist, and I have a song on her last album. She did Love Dance that I wrote with Yvonne Linz, and whenever you find out Barbara's recorded one of your songs, right now I'm working with a group called Daft Punk. So
I
love Daft Punk. So we're writing together right now. But a Streisand cut is like, it's classic. It's classic music when she sings it.
I mean, to say the least.
Yeah, exactly.
Well, thank you so much for your time.
Hey, you're terrific. Thank you.
And for all those stories.
All right.
And keep on doing great stuff online.
God bless everybody in Egypt and everybody applauding for them.
Definitely.